Deep learning at a high level provides you with the unique ability to train models to classify data by feeding the algorithm ground truth. Ground truth refers to information provided by empirical evidence or observation. In artificial intelligence, ground truth refers to data sets with labels to indicate a classification characteristic for your data of interest. For all you Silicon Valley fans out there, do you remember Jinyang's hot dog, not hot dog app? If we were building an application to detect hot dogs, our ground truth would be a label dataset of hot dog images. Labeling can be used for different data artifacts like text, audio signals, images, videos, etc. Now, you can appreciate that with the large amount of data that deep learning applications require, labeling data can be a very labor-intensive process. MATLAB provides you with several tools to help automate this laborious process, namely the image labeler for images, video labeler and ground truth labelers for videos or image sequences, and the signal or audio labeler for digital and audio signals. Let's see how we can use the video labeler app to label a video. Now remember, although we will only show you the video labeler app in this video, the same principles can be applied when using the other labeling tools as well. You can open up the video labeler app from the apps tab or by typing in video labeler into the command prompt. Once the app is launched, click on the load button to load in the data source. In our case, this would be a video file. You can use the playback icons on the bottom to preview the data. Let's assume that we need to label all the big red buoys in this video. Click the label icon to create a new label, and let's give it a name. Labels can be of three kinds: rectangular, line, and pixel labels. One caveat is that only rectangular labels are supported by the built-in automation algorithms. The next step is to mark the ROI in the frame. To do this, let's go back to the start of the frame, select the label, and right-click and drag around the area of interest. We can now employ one of the built-in automation algorithms or add your own custom automation algorithm to automatically label the other frames in the video. In this video, we will take a look at the built-in algorithms, but stay tuned for another video on how to use your own custom algorithm. So first, let's go and select a subset of the data that we need to label. Now, let's select the label and choose an automation algorithm, say point tracker. Clicking on the automation button will take us to the automation pane, which provides you with information on how to use this algorithm on the right-hand side. You can change the settings of the point tracker algorithm to use a different feature detector. Let's choose the MSER feature detector. To learn more about these feature detectors, please take a look at the documentation. Now, clicking on the Run button will automate the process. Once complete, you can use the playback icons on the bottom to verify the labels. And from the looks of it, this algorithm did not work too well for our application. Let's hit the Cancel button to delete all the labels that we've created. And let's choose the temporal interpolator algorithm instead. The temporal interpolator algorithm requires us to label at least two keyframes of interest, and the algorithm will interpolate the location of the bounding box between these two frames. So let's go ahead and label a few frames of interest. Now, once we have labeled a few frames, let's hit Run. We see that the algorithm is able to better track the buoy. Now that we are satisfied with the results, let's click the Accept button. And now you can see that we have a few labeled images. You can now save this session and return to it to continue labeling at a later time. Another kind of label that can be used are scene labels. Scene labels can be used to label entire frames or a range of frames rather than just region of interest. Now that you have a labeled data set, you can export this data to MATLAB as a ground truth data object, which contains information like the data source, the label definitions, and bounding box locations of the regions of interest. This ground truth object can be used to train machine learning and deep learning algorithms in MATLAB. Click on the links in the description to learn how to do this. To conclude, you can use tools like the video labeler, image labeler, and the ground truth labeler to label images and video frames that can be used to train and evaluate object detectors and classifiers. You can also apply the same principles to label signal and audio data using the signal or audio labeler app. Check out the links below to learn more.